Vice President Sara Duterte now giving an interview. Let's listen in.
So kahapon, nasagot natin yung NSC. And then, of course, my response ang NSC. Mamaya na lang natin bigyan ng... Kahapon, nasagot natin ang NNC. May response sila. So mamaya lang natin bigyan ng reply yung sa kanila. Sundin na muna natin yung statement ni ES and yung statement ng PSC. Okay. And then, of course, you want to know updates about the two patients upstairs. So unahin na muna natin yung mga pasyente. Si Attorney Lopez... extended yung detention niya, no? So, meron siyang meetings today with all the lawyers. Nandiyan na rin yung kanyang mother who will join the meetings with the lawyers. So, antay na lang natin kung ano yung galawan ng mga abogado ni Attorney Zulaika Lopez. Health-wise, walang iyak today, kanina, walang iyak. Kausap niya yung mama niya. And dumating din yung best friend niya mula sa Davao City. So, nandiyan sa taas. And kagabi naman, medyo late natulog. And ang pagkakaalam ko, ang endorsement sa akin kagabi, hindi daw masyado kumakain. So, meron silang request na i-encourage siya na kumain. Okay? And the next is Miss Gina Acosta. As you saw during the hearing yesterday, tumaas yung blood pressure niya, 150 over 100. And nawalan siya ng consciousness. Tapos, pagdating niya daw dito sa ER, she was unresponsive. Yung parang ginaganon dito ba, hindi ko alam kung ano yun. Ginaganon dito, she was unresponsive. Pero na-okay naman siya then after. But merong mga nakita ang mga doctor na follow-up check. Kaya in-admit siya today. And then, I visited her this morning. Nagpaalam din ako sa kanya. Day one pa siya sa trauma niya. So, hindi pa masyadong maayos kausap. Tsaka medyo parang pagod. Yes, parang pagod na pagod siya. So, bigyan lang muna natin siya ng time na makausap yung mga doctors niya. And then, tanong natin sa mga doctors kung ano yung pwede sabihin. Tsaka sa patient kung ano yung pwede sabihin. Kagabi, nag-CT scan siya kasi they wanted to rule out a stroke. So, hindi ko rin alam kung anong results. Hindi ko nakita. Hindi din nasabi sa akin. So, tanong lang natin sa patient kung anong part ng medical information niya ang pwede niyang gusto niyang i-share. Kasi pinagalitan ako ni Nicole kagabi dahil binanggit ko daw yung panic and asthma attack niya na medyo na traumatized yung family sa Davao. Yes.
Ma'am, okay. Ano yung reaction ni Attorney Zulaika doon sa extension ko ng pandemya?
Ang sabi niya, na daw siya, she'll take legal steps. Yun yung sabi niya sa akin. And then sinabihan ko siya na, well, hindi na ako sasali sa discussion dyan. Kausapin mo na lang yung mga lawyers mo. Anyway, nag-hire ka man ng lawyers mo. So, ngayon, isa-isa darating yun. Mag-usap sila. Tsaka nandyan din yung mother. Yun din yun sinasabi ng nanay niya because yung nanay niya is used to work for the courts in Davao City. So, merong alam sa batas. In court cases, yung mother ni Yusek Lopez. So, yun din ang sabi ng mama niya. We want to take this to the courts. I do not know with Miss Gina Acosta kasi hindi pa nga siya medyo makapag-isip ng maayos. Pero nasabi sa akin kanina na nag-video call na daw with family. Kasi yung next of kin niya nasa Davao din and some of the relatives nasa United States. Okay?
PSC has doubled the security for the president, for state, and for the first family.
Okay, sige, unahin ko muna yung... Nauna kasi yung statement ni ES eh, tapos lumabas yung sa PSC, okay. No? So unahin ko muna yung kay ES. Meron naman na kayong copy nung kay ES. Ito na lang yung sagot. Nirelease na namin ang written nito. Basahin ko lang. Tapos, yung NBI, I'm sure you want to ask about the NBI. Since hindi ko pa nababasa kung ano yung isi-serve nila sa akin, we will talk about NBI tomorrow. Pag-anuhin nyo lang muna ako kasi kailangan ko din isulat kung ano yung isasagot. So, give me time to read and think about it. Okay, so ito yung sa kay ES, no? This is a reply to the statement issued by the Presidential Communications Office on the order of Executive Secretary Lucas Bersamin dated November 23, 2024. The Marcos administration's insistence that the president's life is under active threat is ominous. I raise this caution as the president and his sycophants aggressively sell a narrative based entirely on my statement, which is taken out of its logical context. Bakit hindi nila pinapalabas kung ano yung question ng media? Bakit hindi nila pinapalabas kung ano yung una kong sagot? Bakit ang pinapalabas lang nila is the last, what, 4 words of my entire statement? They are building a narrative, and I'll tell you kung anong playbook ito. There is absolutely no flesh on the bone, and despite the absence of a reliable investigation, authorities were quick to consider this a national security concern. The diametric contrast and inaction are displayed when I have expressed in previous months threats to my person and the continuing threats to the lives of OVP personnel. Tossing the word assassin. Pakicheck. May sinabi ba akong assassin doon? Wala. So nilalagay nila doon sa narrative nila, assassin. And nilalagay nila sa narrative nila, murder plot. Into this issue, tossing the word assassin into this issue makes things even more terrifying for our country. And especially because I never used that term during my recent consternation against the Marcos administration's failure to serve the Filipinos while it masterfully persecutes political enemies. Common sense should be enough for us to understand and accept that a supposed conditional act of revenge does not constitute to an active threat. This is a plan without a flesh. Pag pinipilit mo siya na active threat siya, isipin ninyo ang buong mundo na nanonood. Ganito ba ang kapasidad ng mga Pilipino na mag-isip? Diba? Ba't wala silang pakialam dyan? Pero ako, nahihiya ako na ganito ang kapasidad ng mga tao sa administrasyon. I am confident that an honest scrutiny would easily expose this narrative to be a farce, imagined, or nothing at all. So, may question kayo. Doan.
You said you were taken out of context, and you also mentioned that they have a playbook.
Yes.
That they're going by.
Yes.
So, can you explain to us that context? Set it straight.
Yes.
And also, explain to us that playbook that you're talking about.
Okay, sige. So the context is, what did I say? I was asked, do you know about the Roman... I'm sorry, ha? I was asking for the transcription of all that I said. I did not get it before I came down. So I have a problem remembering the exact words.
Roughly.
Yes. So there was a question about Romanov, and I said, well, this is the first time that I've heard of that. But I've been warned by two persons already. Two. Be careful. I forget now what the words were said, but I will review my notes and I will tell you what that one person said and how he said to be careful, and that one other person, what that other person said. So, tatlo na yon. One person warned me, another person warned me, and then I was asked during a press briefing by a media person if I know of these plans, if you can say the word, if that is the correct word to use here, plans. So I answered, I was asked, Romanov, and then I answered, I was told by two people, this is the first time I've heard of Romanov, so that is the third already. And I said, don't worry about my security. If they kill me, if I die, kapag pinatay ako, or kapag namatay ako, in the context of, don't worry about my security. So this means, pinatay ka. Diba? Kasi hindi ka naman mamamatay by heart attack in relation to your security. Diba? So, pag namatay ako, I already asked a person to take revenge against 2-3 individuals. So, my question now to the administration, is revenge from the grave a crime?
So, but you already talked to a person.
Yes.
To do that.
Yes.
In the event that you get killed.
Yes. Yes.
So that much is clear.
Yes. So I have to die first. They have to kill me first. They have to kill me first. So now they can't kill me anymore. Unless they want to die. Yes, the playbook. The playbook. Remember, they are known for political persecution. They suppress and oppress opposition. And then somebody was assassinated on the airport tarmac. Diba? They oppress and suppress, and the people were getting angry, frustrated, and what did they do? They created a scenario that there is a national emergency. They set bombs to create a scenario that there is a national emergency. And then they assassinated their political enemy. So that's the playbook. We already saw that in history. So that is my proof. Ang hindi lang po nagawa ni Benigno Aquino Jr., kaya po hindi siya ano bang tawag yan? Revenge? Anong revenge? Nakagante. Hindi siya nakagante. Kasi hindi siya nagbilin. Diba? Kaya, hindi nakagante si Benigno Aquino Jr. kasi hindi siya nagbilin. But you know, Benigno Aquino Jr. is not Sara Duterte. So, ibang tao din siya. Ibang tao din ako.
Vice, right now, sabi ng Department of Justice, ongoing na yung kanilang ginagawa na investigasyon.
Okay.
So, sir, based dun sa naging statement yun.
I have to cut that, sir, because I have to read the subpoena. I've not read it, so I need to write an answer.
So, ma'am, you've not read the subpoena, but just to confirm, you are gonna, when the subpoena is served and you've read it, you are gonna go to the NBI and you're gonna face the NBI.
I cannot answer that because I've not read the what the content of the subpoena is. So, I do not know. So, we'll stop about the subpoena, no? Let's stop talking about DOJ and subpoena and allow me to read through it and then think and then write an answer and then we'll talk.
Ma'am, let's go back to the text. Sabi ni Baden, sabi ni Baden, meron daw kayong assassination attempt. There's assassination against you before your birthday. Can you clarify? Had there been really assassination attempt before your birthday daw po ito, ma'am?
I have not talked to Lorraine Badoy, no? So let me just talk to her and ask her, no, kung ano yung information niya. But we are actually preparing right now a list of proof that they are, ano ba ito? The whole of government is going after one person, and that's me. But kung gusto nyo basahin ko yung PSC, mas ano yon, mas merong, I discussed one threat. So, you wanna do that? You wanna do PSC? Okay, sige. Let's do PSC. But maraming salamat ha, sa pagbabantay ninyo kay Yusek Lopez and kay Gina Acosta. And pakiusap ko lang na bantayan ninyo siya kahit mag-shifting lang kayo, maiwan lang isa just to make sure na kasi may takot din yung nasa taas na actually ang takot ni Yusek Lopez lagi sa gabi. Oo, kasi tulog lahat ng tao, nagpapahinga lahat ng tao. Walang makakapalag. So maraming salamat. Okay, PSC tayo. This is in response to the statement of the Presidential Security Command dated 25 November 2024. The Vice President Security and Protection Group was created and became an armed forces of the Philippines wide support and separate unit by virtue of the Department of National Defense Order signed by former Secretary Delphine Lorenzana dated June 20, 2022 with a corresponding AFP table of personnel and equipment. This was a move to distinguish the security of the Vice President and make it independent. After I resigned from DepEd, nakikita niyo na yung pattern. After I resigned from DepEd, the unit was unceremoniously assigned as a unit under the Presidential Security Command, July 9, 2024, ang order ng DND. Therefore, the security of the Vice President is now under the control of the PSC and as a consequence is influenced by the decisions of the Office of the President. Presuming that the PSC is still a non-partisan professional organization, why is the command eerily quiet on the documented threats to me, my family, and the OVP personnel? The silence. Ito, natural assumption ito natin lahat. The silence is proof that the inclusion of the VPSPG in the PSC is clearly to undermine my security and nothing else. So that's one threat. Bigyan ko kayo ng listahan ng madami with proof. Ito, with proof. There's a DND order.
Separating your security.
Yes, no. Tucking my security under PSC, which is influenced by the decisions of the Office of the President. So ano yan? Lahat ng galaw ko, lahat ng ginagawa ko, kung saan ako, alam niya, alam nila. So anong gagawin nila? Anong value ng information sa kanila after ako mag-resign sa DepEd? Before, when I was with DepEd and working to help the administration, wala namang ganun eh. Diba? Tapos pag mag-resign ka, ganito ang gagawin sa security mo. Imo-monitor ka. Well, that's one threat. So, I'm coming up with a list of threats, pero we'll take that up baka next week na kasi tao lang po. Hindi kaya magsulat ng kayo, mga gagaling kayo, mabilis kayo magsulat. Ako, kailangan ko...
Are you afraid? Are you saying that there's a threat for you to get killed by the administration?
Well, that is a possibility. You see what they're doing right now? That is an example. They are undermining my security. That is just from the PSC. Hindi ko pa dinidiscuss ang galing sa PNP. Diba?
Ano yung intent to fire?
Yung mga yung nagsabi sa'yo ng dalawang tao, anong klaseng threat naman yung sinabi sa'yo, yung binarin sa'yo?
Hindi ko. Mahirap kasi mag-browse ngayon. Hindi ko maalala yung words na ginamit. Oo.
Ma'am, with this...
I don't trust my memory.
Pero in what manner ba? Assassination plot ba yan? Paano ba
yan? Hindi. Iba-iba yung words na ginamit. No assassination plot. But the general message is threat to life. Mm-hmm. Yes.
So, ingat lang yung sentence, something like that.
Huwag niyo lang muna i-quote ha, kasi hindi ko maalala. I don't trust my memory right now, so I need to review the notes so that I give you a verbatim record of what was sent by the two individuals.
Well, with this, do you also intend to double your security also, like the PSC, like what they're doing now to the first family of the president?
Hindi ko na ini-expect yan, ma'am, sa PSC. And hindi ko rin tatanggapin, ma'am, at this point, kung magdadagdag sila ng mga tao dito. Kasi hindi na natin alam kung non-partisan ba yung idadagdag nila.
Not necessarily coming from PSC, ma'am.
No, I don't trust anyone right now. So yes.
Even
if PSC acts on what I said, no, I will not accept it anymore. That is what I did with PNP. Hindi na. Kasi hindi na natin alam eh. Baka igagawin pa yan nilang rason na maglagay ng mga tao diyan na nagtatrabaho para sa kanila. So,
okay, last two questions.
Do you share the same sentiments as your father? Former president last night.
What
he
are
said,
his sentiments?
So last night he asked the military if they would continue to support fractured governance and a leader who is a drug addict.
I agree. So sandali. I agree with fractured governance. I was a member of cabinet, so I have personal knowledge. I agree with fractured governance. I agree with the assumption that he is a drug addict because he continuously refuses to do a drug test. Napakadali naman, di ba? Tulad ko, napakadali naman. Sinabi ko kaagad, gusto niyo ng neuropsychiatric test o kung ano pa man yung test na gusto niyo i-take ko. Gusto niyo ulitin ko yung bar exams. Lahat yan, gagawin ko. No questions asked. Gusto niyo ng drug test? Sabi ko, dagdagan ko pa ng drug test. Napakadali gawin sa akin yan. Ngayon kaagad na araw na ito, gawin natin yan. Pero, lahat, sabi ko nga, sisimulan namin sa Office of the Vice President ang drug test, kaming lahat. Diba? So, dapat tayong lahat sa gobyerno, mag-drug test tayong lahat. Lahat ng mga congressman ninyo, pa-drug test nyo.
What about so that, are the you... question for the military?
No, I do not agree with that. So, as I said, i-qualify nyo yung answer ko, I agree. With a fractured government. I have personal knowledge. I was a member of cabinet. I agree with the assumption that he is a drug addict. I think mine is assumption. I think the former president has evidence that he really is a drug addict. So, pareho lang din yun.
Ma'am, are you a threat? Sorry.
Sabi ko nga, diba, noong kailan ba yun, nagsalita ako, Sabi ko, dalawa lang naman hinihingi natin. Diba? As politicians, ibigay natin yung pangako natin sa mga tao. Diba? Ako, bumoto ako. Kasi sinabi 20 pesos ang per kilo ng bigas. And that would help so many families right now. Diba? Pangalawa, tingnan natin ang katinuan ng lahat. Diba? Pa-drug test nyo din yung AFP. Pa-drug test nyo din yung lahat ng PNP. But somehow, hanggang ngayon, OVP pa lang din ang papa-drug test. I wonder why.
Last question, please.
No, hindi ako tao na nagpapa-areglo. Tsaka hindi ako tao na nabibili ng pera.
Ma'am, are you a threat now to national security?
Am I a threat to national security? What they are doing to me is a threat. Sagot ko yan sa NSC mamaya bukas.
Okay.
Ma'am, may nabanggit na may binigay sa inyo sobre si First Lady Lisa Araneta Marcos. Para saan ba yun?
Yes, I'm waiting for that question to come up in the committee hearing. So let's wait for that question to come up in the committee hearing.
Friday, will you be able to attend the next hearing?
Yes, I'm free on Friday. Tomorrow, I'll be in Basilan. And then Thursday, I'll be in Lingayen, Pangasinan. And then Friday, I'm free.
So you're ready to answer all their questions now?
I will answer my questions because I need to be there to help the other OVP personnel. They have expressed that they feel safer and they feel more comfortable if I am with them. But I will not be recognized if I don't take my oath. So I am forced to take my oath and answer questions under oath because I cannot take care of the OVP personnel.
But for example, to explain how 125 million pesos were spent within a matter of 11 days, or they have questions about acknowledgement receipts, will you explain all those or answer all those questions?
Isn't it that they've been asking those questions from the resource persons, from COA, from the OVP personnel? So why will I answer again? I already answered when we sent our answers to the Commission on Audit. It was clear there. In fact, ayaw ko naman kasi mag-discuss ng CF ba, but in fact, the 125 confidential funds had a notice of disallowance, but not the entire amount. Let's make that clear. Not the entire amount of the 125 million was disallowed by the Commission on Audit. Meaning, all the rest of the funds, I do not have the number right now. I think it's approximately 70 million that was disallowed. But that is subject to appeal. Because gusto ko ba sabihin ito sa inyo? Dahil during the discussion, I was telling the lawyer to submit a document. But the lawyer said, no, you know, when lawyers are discussing and they have their own positions, it's really a difficult meeting to do. I said to submit. And then the other lawyer said, do not submit. Ay di lumabas yung disallowance. And then sinabihan ko yung lawyer, sabi ko, tingnan mo, lumabas yung disallowance. Sabi ko, sa appeal, ilabas mo yung document.
Ma'am, si Colonel Achika and Colonel Lasco na nabanggit po naman.
Wait lang ha, so tapusin ko lang. And then, so, cleared na yon. The first, second, and third quarters, undergoing audit. Merong AOM na sinasagot namin ngayon. Okay? For DepEd, the first and second quarters, may credit notice na yon. Ibig sabihin, cleared na ang buong pera. Diba? Ewan ko lang kung sinasabi ito ng mga congressman. Of course, hindi nila sinasabi, diba? Because they want to present their own narrative. Tapos na yon. The money in DepEd, first and second quarter, cleared with credit notice. The ongoing audit is on the third quarter only. And it's ongoing. So you cannot question an ongoing audit. And you cannot audit the funds of any government office because that is the exclusive domain of the Commission on Audit. Bakit nag-audit ang ating mga congressman? Dapat sila gumagawa ng batas. Nakikita nyo? Sinasabi na nila ngayon, in the proper time, we will legislate. Kasi sinasabi namin eh, where is the proposed legislation? Hinahanap namin. So ngayon, dinadagdag na nila yon. Madali lang naman siya eh. Pakinggan nyo lang, basahin nyo lang lahat ng mga nangyayari. Madali lang maintindihan kung anong ginagawa nila. Okay.
Last question, please. Last question. Humarap na si Colonel the last point, Colonel Ajika, mas maiintindihan na ba ng publiko at ng Kongreso itong paggastos po ng confidential funds?
Really, I still say that confidential funds, the use of confidential funds cannot be divulged. Sinasabi ko pa rin yan. They cannot be divulged in public. It will compromise lives and security of personnel who are cooperating or who are nandoon sa kabila na asset. You cannot do that. That is why it is called confidential funds.
Last question, can we just get your reaction dun sa comment po ng ilang congressmen na parang nagkakasakit daw po yung mga staff pag humaharap sa pagdinig?
Oo, kasi tineterrorize nila. Of course, magkakasakit talaga ang tao na hinaharas mo, tineterrorize mo. Ako lang naman ang hindi nagkakasakit dahil politiko ako. You can terrorize me and harass me all you want. It does not matter to me. Pero these are ordinary Office of the Vice President employees. They are not politicians. They are ordinary citizens. So, pag hinaras mo yan, terrorize mo yan, eh ganyan talaga mangyayari. Sinasabihan ko yung doktor kagabi, Dok, i-clear nyo yan na mag-attend ulit. Kung sa susunod, diretsong stroke na yan. Ngayon, swerte tayo, hindi na stroke, hindi na heart attack. But the family has a history of heart attack. Lahat ng kanyang ang parents and some relatives, heart attack lahat ang ikinamatay. So, ano ba? Papaupuin pa ba natin doon? Tapos antayin natin, ay, na heart attack. Yes. Diba? So, yes, yes. So, yes. Yes, Mr. Billionario, pahingi ng pera.
Last one, critics din, ano, they're saying, yes. Of course, you've already said that you're here almost 24/7 because you're concerned about your staff.
Yes.
Some of your critics say you're here 24/7 because you're afraid that they might say something, they might divulge something that might incriminate you.
They are attending the Yusek Lopez attended the hearing. They can ask her questions there. I was not there when Yusek Lopez attended the hearing, so I was not there to influence her and tell her what to answer. If you saw me yesterday, I was not looking at Gina Acosta. I was studying. I was reading laws. I was studying the rules of the... Para na akong congressman ngayon, tanong niyo ako kung anong rules nila. I was studying the rules of the House of Representatives. I was not looking at her. Pinapabayaan ko siya sumagot. Siguro umiiling-iling ako paminsan-minsan dahil I feel na hindi dapat dinadivulge sa public yung ibang mga sinasabi na ng kasama ko, pero wala akong magawa. Wala akong magawa. Kasi ayaw namin na ma-detain sila. So, sumasagot talaga sila. Si Edward Fajarda, not once did I coach him. Pero si Gina, I helped her with the term detail kasi she was trying to remember kung anong tawag nung isang tao na galing sa isang opisina, na nililipat sa isang opisina, and that is called detail. So I told her detail, and she said details.
Okay. Yung money na siya. Yung CFS from SDO, yung minerasyo daw sa mga security officer, yun talaga mamang nature ba ng confidential funds?
Yes, there is an SDO, and there is a security officer, and there is a head of agency. So, ako yung head of agency, may SDO kami, may security officer kami. Ganun talaga ang structure. Again, sinabi ko ito sa mga, wala kasing mainstream noon ba? Again, so alam natin lahat ng, mahalikan ko na yung ano ni New.
Subo yung mic.
Mic, please.
Ayoko itong pula. Saan galing yan? Ayun! Okay. Saan? Saan ako? Ah, okay, okay. Alam nyo, di ba, meron kayong mga naririnig ng akusasyon ng nakawan dito sa ating gobyerno. Corruption in government. Naririnig nyo ba na millions ang ninanakaw? Hindi, di ba? Ang naririnig nyo, billions ang ninanakaw sa budget natin. Alam nyo, bakit 150 million lang yon? Kasi kinompute yun kung buwan-buwan ano ang gagawin at ano ang i-implement. Napakaliit na amount ang 150 million. So bakit kami magnanakaw ng 150 million? Ang nakawan sa gobyerno, billion-billion. Ginamit yun sa trabaho. Bakit 125 plus 500 lang yung sa Office of the Vice President? Kasi kinompute yun. Buwan-buwan. Ang problem sa 125, binigay siya sa amin December na. And requirement in government offices, you have to utilize money before December 31, before the end of the year. So ang ginawa, lahat ng preps in-implement. Saba? And as I said, government offices disburse millions, billions in a day. Sa DepEd, nagdi-disperse kami. Disburse. Nagdi-disperse. Pumipirma kami ng cheque. Multi-million. Kung itotal mo ang mga checks araw-araw na nalalabas sa DepEd, billions. Nagbabayad kami, nagbabayad, nagbabayad. So, bakit nila kine-question yung pagbabayad ng millions in a day? And that is, ano, part of work of government offices to disburse money every day and pay obligations. Ginamit yun sa trabaho. Pinipilit lang talaga. Dalawa na ang maro ko. Si Marisol at si JC. Ah, tama na, tama na. Anong oras na? Oh, kasi alauna na, and I have to be back tonight. Ayaw nila ng gabi. Na ano sila sa gabi. Yes. But tomorrow, balikan ako Basilan. I leave in the early morning. Yes, leave early morning. And then, balik ako sa gabi. May flights naman. Nandiyan mama niya. Tsaka nandiyan yung lawyers niya. And ayoko makipag-usap sa mga abogado kasi lahat ng mga abogado, pag nag-uusap-usap sila, magaling lahat ba? Diba? Lahat sila. Ako yung magaling. So parang ayoko sumali sa legal discussion.
Ma'am, gano'ng kahabang listahan ng contracts sa inyo?
Or sit down daw, sabi ni JC.
Bye! Ma'am, may papaalam kami. Ma'am, can we stay here? Kasi binagkasi kami sa araw. Kasi doon talaga kami. So, doon ito. Pwede dito. Dito lang kami sa gitna.
Pero, kuha ko masusunod dito sila.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, yung sunblock niya, ubos na.
All right, Vice President Sara Duterte there, opening herself to a lot of questions this afternoon, ranging from her reaction to the statement of Executive Secretary Lucas Bersamin, also reacting to how the palace reacted to her statements in the past few days.